guys, Sarah here. So today I am going to review another book that I read recently called Daisy Miller by Henry James. And as you can see, I did get this from the library. I wasn't going to buy a book that was this thin, but I had heard about it, so I decided to read it, and I will give you guys a short summary and my review of the book. So let's begin. Alright, so at the beginning of the book, we have Mr. Winterbourne, an American man who has lived in Geneva all his life, in Switzerland, if you didn't know where that was. He has lived there, and he is at a hotel one summer, and he meets this American girl named Daisy Miller, who is there with her brother Randolph and her mother, and they just travel around Europe during the summer, and they're just kind of moving around. They're from a small town in New York. And she is kind of portrayed as if she is in high society back here in America, but the way she comes off in front of Mr. Winterbourne is quite undignified and quite uneducated socially. And she really displays how Europeans kind of take Americans and kind of see us, in the sense that we seem to be more outgoing and not confident necessarily, because that depends more on like each individual, but more in a sense that they kind of just say what's on their mind, whereas in Europe there was, at that time, there was more of a sense of social standing and status. That was what was more important. And as Americans, I guess, since we didn't have even titles of nobility, that just didn't bother people. And Mr. Winterbourne realizes that once he meets her, that she doesn't care that she's walking outside with a man, and in Europe that's not seen as morally or socially correct. And this is, by the way, is Mr. Winterbourne, if you can see that, and that's supposed to be Daisy Miller, even though in the book she's blonde. The rest of the book, I'm not going to spoil anything for you. It is simply Mr. Winterbourne observing Daisy and how she acts in front of people, and him trying to pinpoint if she really does fit that American stereotype of being a flirt with every European guy she meets, or is that just kind of her image, but is there really more to her than meets the eye? Is she different in that way? And he's just fascinated by this, and the novel continues as Mr. Winterbourne tries to analyze her persona, and he tries to figure out who she is and what she means by acting in such a way. I thought this book was very good. I actually really enjoyed it. It was a very short and easy read. I had to read this in parts, though, because since I am in school, I had a lot of homework. I couldn't come home every day and just drop everything and read this book. So it did actually take me an embarrassingly long time, considering how thin this is. But once you put it in context, it was a short read. I read for only like 15 to 20 minutes at a time, and I read this in about 3 days. I have to say that I do appreciate, since this is from the 1900s, that the writing is very easy to read. There's no words that I have to go back in a dictionary and find. There's none of that Charles Dickens, where you have to find a word and actually find out what it means. I do like the way the plot moves, even though it is a story that just deals with specific moments across a scattered period of time, and it did deal with a very small portion of the bigger picture, which was just Mr. Winterbourne in his view of Daisy Miller. I still appreciated that it was one of those books that it's just about one moment in time, or a few moments, and it's just a very nice memory once you close the book and once you finish. I really did like that. I don't think that every book has to necessarily have some incredible moment where there's a hero, because this book wasn't a quest, it was more of a memoir. And if you look at it that way, it is a very nice read. It's pleasant, and it is written well. I recommend it to anyone who likes books from a specific era. Well, I hope you guys find this book. It's anywhere you want, Amazon. I saw it at a Barnes & Noble if you're looking for it. But I would say, why don't you just read this online? Because this is a really tiny book to buy just for... I think this book is seriously 67 pages. So that was it. This is Daisy Miller once more, if you forgot the title. I hope you guys enjoyed this review. I really hope I made it in 5 minutes, because last time I said I thought I made it in 5 minutes, and I was way off. I'll try to make this short. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope to see you guys soon, and there will also be more videos soon. Bye! I'm just gonna open the window. I just realized there's still sunlight outside. My bad.